here from H3D CGI, and before we go ahead and get started with this tutorial, I wanted to give you guys a general introduction to the tutorial and also H3D CGI to tell you guys what we are trying to create and what we are all about. If you guys wanted to skip the introduction and just get on with the tutorial, there should be an annotation so you can click that and get straight to the tutorial. So basically, I'm just going to give you guys a general walkthrough of our website that you can see on the screen at the moment. We're a newly created 3D website / YouTube channel. And basically what we are trying to create is very similar to CG Pro's YouTube channel, where you're most likely watching this tutorial. But instead of dealing with inspirational videos, we're trying to create a channel where you can find tutorials for all your needs. So we do have tutorials from our in-house authors, such as me, who create tutorials. And we also have authors from all around YouTube who create tutorials for us, and also who we use where we use their tutorials from to try to build up a massive channel with loads of tutorials. So on our website, you can find tutorials that we already have in 3D Studio Max, Maya, After Effects, Blender, texturing, and we also have a coming soon section that we're currently working on, so you can see what we're going to have later on down the line. We're also going to deal with some programming in C++ and Python. And as you can tell, we have a section for inspirational videos. Most of them are from the CG Bros, so you can find their stuff on their YouTube channel. If you're watching this on our YouTube channel, make sure you go ahead and check out CG Bros. We also deal with news, so such as 3D industry news that you can find down here. And we also have a Facebook page, so make sure you go ahead and like us if you enjoy what we are trying to do here. So without any further ado, let's go ahead and get started with the tutorial. And before we go ahead and start creating anything, I'll give you guys an introduction to this as well. So basically, this tutorial is going to be for the complete beginners or the very beginners who just started out modeling. If you only just started out modeling and you're still not very comfortable with working in 3D space, then I do advise you watching this. If you're fairly intermediate, then you might not learn anything new. So the first thing we're going to do is, as you can tell, I've got two models here and they look very similar. The only difference is that one of them is a low poly version and the other one is a high poly version, and you might have heard these terms before and you're not sure what these exactly mean. So I'll just show you the first low poly version, and as you can tell, this is what it looks like. And a poly is basically a polygon, so that's a face on the model, and it's a measure of how detailed the model is. So for example, if I just go to display, heads up display, and go to display poly count, as you can tell, if I select the low poly model, it's only about 8,000 faces, which is not that low poly, but it's fairly low poly compared to the high poly version that we have here. So if I go ahead and select that, that's about 300,000 faces, so that will take a lot more computing power to display and also to render. So for example, for games, we would prefer to use a low poly version. So in this tutorial, we're going to go ahead and create a low poly version because it takes less tools and techniques to create, so you don't have to worry about adding in all extra edge loops and smoothing and so on. So in this tutorial, we're just going to go through the very basics, and then later on down the line, once you are more comfortable in working in 3D space and so on, we'll start creating more advanced models in smooth mode and so on. So I'll just show you guys one more example. As you can tell, in the high poly version, we get a very nice bevel down the edges. So this will give us a very nice highlight on the model. And if you have a look on the low poly version, we don't get a highlight at all. So that's the reason why once we go ahead and render this, basically it will look a lot nicer, and also all the curves and everything is a lot smoother. That will make it look a lot better. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started with the tutorial. I'm just going to go ahead and delete this low poly version and also the high poly version. I'm just going to go ahead and delete both of them. And before we go ahead and get started, I'm just going to go ahead and turn off my display, so the poly count, and also we're going to go ahead and go to display and UI elements, dotted line, this would tear off this window. So as you can tell, it will come into a separate window, and I'm just going to go to show all UI elements. So this way I can go ahead and reset my workspace, and I'm also going to go to display and turn on the grid, and hopefully I'll get something like your screen. Now what we're going to do is we can turn some of this stuff off so it's out of our way. I'm going to go ahead and turn off our command line because we're not doing any programming. We're going to turn off the range slider, the time slider because we're not doing any animation. I'm also going to go ahead and turn off the tool settings because we can get that up on me later. I'm also going to click this icon to go to full screen, and hopefully I should get something like your screen. Now if you just started out, you're going to have to go to the polygons tab and the polygons shelf, and now hopefully our screen looks exactly the same. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and create the base of our model. So we're going to go ahead and use a cylinder, and also in the create tab you should have interactive creation turned on, so just make sure this is checked on, and that way it will be exactly the same. So I'm going to go ahead and click our cylinder, and then we're going to go ahead and drag on out in around the middle of our grid. So I'm clicking drag and then let go, click and drag again to give it a height, and as you can tell we got our cylinder. Now as you can notice in our channel box this will pop up, and what we're going to do in the X direction, we're going to zero this out, and this way it will move it exactly into the center of our grid like so. Okay, so you got a base, and in the inputs if you go to poly cylinder 1 you can find the settings that we added for the cylinder, so you can always go back and change the radius. If you hold down middle mouse button and drag, you can change the radius, we can change the height. Okay, and we also can change the subdivision axis. For this one we're going to turn this up to about 30 just to get a smoother version. Okay, so we got a base selected, and hopefully you already know how to move around and that, so I don't want to go through into that much beginner details. But basically it's holding down alt and left mouse button to rotate, alt and middle mouse button to move around, and then alt and right button to zoom in. Okay, so we can also click our model or our selected object and press F, and that way it will rotate around and move around our object. So now that we have our base, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and duplicate this cylinder. So let's go ahead and hit Control D to duplicate, and now I'm just going to press W to move this up, and then scale by pressing R on my keyboard. I'm going to scale this down a little bit. I'm also going to go ahead and move this down a bit more, so you get these two sort of steps. So the next thing we're going to create is we're going to create the cylinders that are going to come up, so sort of support panels. And what I'm going to do is if you hold down space and then go to modify, make live, this will make this object basically act like our grid. So whenever we go ahead and drag an object, it will drag it on our shape and not on the grid. Okay, you can also do this by going up here to modify and make live, but I kind of like to use the shortcut of holding down this, and it will bring up this fairly complicated menu, but once you start using it, it's not that complicated. So if you hold down space and then go to modify, left mouse button and drag to make live, then you should get the same result. So once we have that, we're going to go ahead and go to our cylinder, and we're going to go ahead in our top view, and again changing viewports, you can do it many ways. You can press space once, and if you're in right viewport then it will come out and go back in. So I can press space to go in and out, but I don't really like using this. So instead, the way I change viewport is by holding down space, and then in the mayor icon, if you left click and drag, you can go into different viewports. Okay, and I find this the fastest way of doing it. And once you get used to it, it's very quick to change viewports. Okay, so I'm now just going to go ahead and go into my top view, so let go, and there we go, I just went into my top viewport. So it's the still got a cylinder selected, so I'm going to go ahead and drag one out in one of these faces. Now I can gonna go into my side view and zoom out a bit so I can drag out a height. I'm going to drag it out fairly high, probably roughly around there. Okay, so once I have that, I'm going to go back into my top view. I'm just going to go ahead and move this roughly in the center of that face. Now, a little different way we can also do this is I can go ahead and click this icon and hold down once I made this unlive. So we're just going to go to modify, make live, and then go to modify, make not live. And what I'm going to do is select a cylinder, make sure that I got this axis selected, and then hold down X to snap this to the center, I mean to this grid point here. I'm also going to go ahead and turn on our wireframe by pressing this icon, and now we got this exactly in the center. So once I have that, basically what I want to achieve is that I want more cylinders like this in every face in here. Okay, so I basically just want to duplicate it and move it around. Now you can do this the hard way, so you can go ahead and press Ctrl D to duplicate and then move it here and then move it up. Now this wouldn't be a very good way of doing it, so instead what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and move a pivot point of this object into the center of this cylinder. Now what this will let us do is that when we go ahead and rotate, if you notice, if I press E to rotate now and rotate it, it will rotate around the center of that object. Now if you go ahead and move the pivot point here and we rotate it, then the object will pivot or rotate around the center of that point. Okay, so basically let's go ahead and do that and it will be easier to go ahead and explain. So I'm just going to go ahead and press insert on my keyboard, and that way it will bring up this little icon, which means you're in the moving pivot mode. So you can go ahead and move our pivot point there. Now you can do this manually again, which wouldn't be a good idea. So instead of moving this manually, what we're going to do is we're going to hold down V on our keyboard to snap to a vertex. So I'm going to hold down V and then middle mouse button, click in the center of that object, okay, and that way it will snap to that vertex, which will be exactly in the center. Now we can press insert again to come out of our modify pivot mode, and as you can tell, if I go ahead and rotate this object now, it will rotate around that point. So I'm going to go ahead and undo this, and what I want is basically I want this to rotate around here. And if we look in our rotate Y, if you change this to about minus 12, most likely it will sit exactly in the center. So now we can go ahead and duplicate this again and change this to minus 24 and so on. But this would again take a little bit too much time. So instead, what we're going to do is now that we've rotated it, we can press Shift D instead of Control D. And what it's going to do is going to rotate, and it will also, I mean, it will duplicate and it will also rotate it an extra 12 degrees again. So whatever our last action was. So now we can just go ahead and Shift D all the way around and it will duplicate and rotate 12 degrees each time. And bam, there we go. So we got all our cylinders moved around. So it's a very easy way to go ahead and duplicate multiple objects. So once we have this, what I'm also going to do is we're going to go ahead and give this a little base at the bottom. So we could go ahead and create a new cylinder and move it in the right place. But instead, we're going to start to get your head around reusing assets, okay, or objects that you already have. So for example, we already have a cylinder here. So what I can do is I can just duplicate this. I can go ahead and scale this down, probably around that big. And I obviously want this a little bit thicker, so you can go ahead and scale this up. Now that we have that, we can go ahead and move this down to the base where I want this, like so. And now what we can do is obviously go around again and duplicate this. Now there's a different way of duplicating, and again we need to go ahead and move our pivot point. So I'm press insert, hold down V, middle mouse button, drag in the middle, and press insert again. So we could go ahead and duplicate this again and then rotate it 12 degrees. And then go ahead and keep doing that with the Shift D. Or you can also go ahead and use the edit duplicate special command. So if you press this little square next to it, this will bring this up. So we can change many settings here, but we're going to go ahead and just use the rotate command. So it's going to be rotate Y. So we're going to go ahead and this is X, this is Y, and this is Z. So we're going to need it to rotate 12 degrees on the Y axis, okay? And it's going to be a copy, not an instance. And also it's going to be a parent, so it's going to probably group them together. And the scale, make sure that it's untouched, so it's going to be 1 all the way around. And translate is going to be 0 as well. Now you can change the number of copies here. So let's go ahead and try 10 and see what happens. So I'm just going to go ahead and press apply. And as you can tell, it duplicated all the way around our pivot. Now we could go ahead and select this again. And let's say change this to 20 and apply again. And I think that was a little bit too much. So I'm just going to close this window and go ahead and delete these ones that we don't need, the extra ones. So we already had one there. We already had one here. Here. So I'm now just selecting them rings and deleting them. So this is another way of duplicating many objects, okay? The duplicate special. So now that we have them rings, I basically want these rings all the way up here on the top as well, because we're gonna have something sitting up here. So what we're gonna do, instead of creating them again, like I said, we're gonna go ahead and reuse these assets and just duplicate them all up and move them up. Now I'll also introduce you to the idea of the outliner, which is this. So if you click this icon, it will come up. And here you can find all the objects that you created. Now what we are looking for is these little cylinders that sit there. So I'm just going to hold down Shift, left click all the way around to see the ones that I need. And I need that one, and that one. So now I have all of them selected. And we're going to press Control G to group them together. We can also go ahead and name this if you want it to, but we're going to leave it as Group 1. So now I'm going to press W on my keyboard to go into my Move tool, and I'm going to go ahead and press Control D to duplicate this group, and now we can move them all up. So I want them up here, and we got our little caps for these as well. Great. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and create the little rim sort of thing for this, or we can also actually use this instead. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this and duplicate that, Control D, and then move this up, and I want it a little bit smaller, so I'm just going to move this up in the right place and then press R to scale. I'm going to go ahead and scale this in around that much. Okay, that's great. So once we have this, we're going to go ahead and duplicate this one more time. Control D, move this up, and then scale it in. And now what we're going to do, we're going to create the top of this, so that it's sort of sphere that you've seen before. So what I'm going to do is we're going to go into our side view, and we can go ahead and use a sphere for this. So here's my sphere. I'm going to go ahead and drag this out roughly around the center. Actually, it would probably be better if you'd done this in top view, so let's go ahead and do that. So again, in the center, just drag one out, and then now I'm going to go into my side view and move this up. Now we only need half of it and not all of it, because if I set this on the top, then the other half will be sitting on the bottom, and I don't want that. So what we're going to do is go into our right click the mesh, go into our face mode, and then we're going to go ahead and select these bottom faces and just press delete to delete them, so that way we'll only have this. And now what I'm going to do is I want this to sit exactly in the center, so again I'm going to go to translate Z and zero it, and also translate X, I'm going to zero that as well. So now I can go ahead and move this down to where I need it. And also go ahead and scale this up so it will sit around there roughly. Okay, so we just finished this fit, and this is it for this part of the tutorial. I'm kind of going over the time limit that I have, so in the next couple of parts we're going to go ahead and finish this off, and we'll also go ahead and add some extra details to this that you haven't seen in the preview model. So I hope you guys enjoy this tutorial. If you do, please go come over to our channel at Edge3DCGI if you're not already there, and subscribe to us, and also make sure you like us on Facebook. So I'll see you guys.